Wise Money Transfer Tutorial, How to Use Wise for Beginners. Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm giving you a tutorial on Wise Money Transfer, how you can transfer money anywhere, anytime. So let's get into it. First of all, you're going to go to wise.com and you will land on this website right here. Now, Wise is a platform that allows you to send and receive money to up to like 170 countries and in more than 50 currencies. All you need to do is just create an account and you will be able to then send and receive money very easily. So once you get to wise.com, now there are two types of Wise accounts that we can create. There is a personal Wise account and then there is a business Wise account. Now, if you have a large business where you do thousands of dollars of transaction, then you can go with the business account. Because with business account, you will have to provide your business information, you will have to verify your business. But if you do transactions within, I think, 20,000 or 10,000, then you can go with the personal account. A personal account is to send money to your family, maybe send money for, you know, your online shopping, any kind of payment. So that's why we use the personal account. So I'm going to go with the personal one because this one is very easy to use and you can get started. So once you select the type, now you can click on open an account. So to create an account, you will require an email address. So you will need to enter it right here. Click on next. Then here you have to select the personal or the business. So I'm going to go with personal. Select your country. And this is where you'll verify your phone number. And after that, you will set up a password. So once you enter your information, now keep in mind, creating an account on Wise, you need to add your right information. You will need to enter your name that you have on your ID and you will actually need to verify that. So you can create an account on Wise. Just make sure to add the right information and the name on your account matches your name on your bank. So you need to provide the right information because if you don't, then your Wise will not work. Once you add and you provide the right information, then you will get your own Wise account. And this is what it looks like. You can see this is our home. Now, home will look actually a little bit different because at the top here, you will get all of your information about your different, you know, currencies for privacy reasons. So for privacy reasons, you can see at the top, we have our currency where you'll be able to find different currencies. You can have more than one currencies within your Wise account. You can have like USD, you can have maybe your personal currency. So with Wise, you get your own US bank. So that's the thing. Whenever you open up any of the, you know, currency within your Wise, that means you open up, you know, your account, your own profile of that currency within your Wise. At this side of the screen, you can find the send money option and request money. Now, to send money, you just click on this option. So here we have send money. Where do you want to send from? Here you will select your balance. For instance, I want to send from here. So here we have this amount. Now you can see this will show us our, you know, rate, and the rates are guaranteed, and you can send this to any other currency. Let's say I want to send to USD actually. So I'm going to scroll all the way down to USD here and it will show me that how many USD the other person will get. So if it's international, then this is what it will look like and it has like a little bit more amount. And then you can also go to the same currency and then the fee is actually, there is no fee for the same currency and it's completely free. So you can see they will get the exact same amount, that person, if you're sending the same currency. So this is actually pretty impressive. Then you have to add the recipient's information. So in recipient's information, you can select if you want to go with myself or someone else or business or charity. So we're going to go with someone else here. Now you have to enter their email address. So this is optional because we're sending directly to them. So you can select their local bank here. For that, you will need to enter the account holder name. Then you have to enter their, I am going with UK, right? So I will need to add that code and the account number. But it depends on the account where you're sending the money. Then we have the account holder's number. You can also go with the IBAN. Click on continue. and then it will show you a review and your money will be transferred to that account. So sending money is really easy with Wise, and it actually takes like a few minutes for Wise to send the money, and the other person gets the money in like few minutes. To request the money, you just simply click on request and it will take you right here. Enter the amount you want to, you know, ask the other person. Let's say I want someone to send me 100 USD. So you enter the amount and then you select the currency. Because I have my currencies in these two, so I can just request these two, like USD and GBP. So I'm going to go with this one. Add a note. So this is where you add a note. For instance, I did a online work. So I'm just going to add a reference here. Online work. Now click on create payment link and your payment link will be created. Now this is the link that you share. Now I'm just going to click on open or copy the link. I will copy the link and send this to that person to whom I'm requesting the money from. So it's actually really easy. But this link actually works with Wise, and it also has an expiry date here. So this one works with Wise. They'll be able to open their Wise and send me money on Wise. This is not the direct transaction to the bank account. Keep that in mind. With Wise, I showed you send money and request money. After that, we have cards. You can also request a card that Wise sends, and you can actually withdraw the money with a card. So you can go to the card section there. If you want to add a new recipient to your Wise account, so you can just go to the recipient. And as I showed you, you add their information. You can add their IBAN. If you're adding a bank account, then you will need to enter their, you know, full name, and then you will have to enter their, you know, address and the account information. Then we have manage. So this is our manage your account. This is where I can find my account details, direct debits, make a donation, and more. So with direct debit, I can actually set up my direct debit transactions with Wise too. So we also have statements and reports. Using wise.com is really easy. You will also get the notifications here at the top. Go ahead and create your account with wise.com and you'll be able to, you know, simply send and receive money within minutes. If you talk about the fee of Wise, then you can actually go to the pricing. Wise.com/pricing, and you can scroll down to check the fee. So registering for Wise account is completely free. Sending money is 0.43%. Spending with your card is withdrawing is free. ATM fee, you can see 2%. So you can actually get all of the information about the receiving and sending money. The fee and everything will be mentioned here. So this one is actually really useful. You can go to wise.com/pricing. This brings us to the end of the video. I hope that I was a big help. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Leave a comment down below. Turn on bell notification and subscribe to YouTube channel.